Here they come. Team.
Hey. So, we're recording this Thursday morning, January 7th, and it's been a crazy 24 hours.
Yeah.
Normally, we would record this on Wednesdays, but yesterday we decided that we needed to wait. And I don't know about the two of you, but I've had a whole lot of feelings in the last 24 hours. Just real sadness, some shock, disgust, anger, a little bit of hope sprinkled in there sometimes. It's felt like the fabric of our nation, which has been tearing for a while, and I don't mean just like 4 years ago, I mean like for a couple decades, that was a significant rip that we experienced yesterday. And it appears to be holding, but holy God, we've got some work to do.
Yeah. Not the epiphany I was expecting yesterday.
Yeah. It's not the manifestation that we've been looking forward to. So as you guys were going to bed last night, what were in your thoughts and prayers?
I think I went to bed just as they went into separate sessions on Pennsylvania, roughly, and was actually feeling a lot of gratitude for those people for sacrificing the way they did and making the decision they did to keep going last night. That was my overwhelming feeling, was like they had like just broke for dinner and it was like 11 p.m. over there. And I was like, good on them. They just had a traumatizing day and they stuck with it and were like, no, we're making this decision. Nothing's going to stop us. That felt like a really hopeful moment for me.
Yeah.
I felt a lot of gratitude.
Yeah, I felt similarly, actually, just like watching the or seeing the images of people like ducked down wearing gas masks and then like them in the same space a few hours later, like carrying on with their work. And I think Emily, I echo a lot of your sentiment, like that they just kept going and seeing all those like people carrying in the like, boxes, and it felt like. Like, yeah, there's a responsibility here and we're gonna just keep going with it. I don't know. But I had a lot of also the other feelings of like kind of just rage and anger and frustration. And
yeah, I was watching some of the speeches, mostly in the Senate, because they started first, going back, and I totally agree. I think that was one of the most important things that happened in our nation's history yesterday, was that after they cleared the Capitol, the Congress went back to work. That was like so critical, I believe, because what it did is I think it reset some of the emotional stability to say, that's not all of who we are. It's part of who we are, and we have forgotten that at our peril. Mm-hmm. But that's not all of who we are by any means. But to hear senators like Duckworth out of Illinois, I thought she gave an incredible speech on the floor of the Senate. Senator Warner, Senator Romney, it was like, okay, there is still an understanding of like who we are in this country. Which I think that's the work ahead of us. And I mean, by us, I mean like country, but also us at All Souls in Berkeley, in this little corner of this country, we have some work set out for us. And I believe we can do it, at least do our part faithfully. Mm-hmm. And I'm ready to do it with the two of you and with All Soulsians everywhere. So, What's that work going to look like?
It's a great question.
It's a great question.
It might actually look like getting together to worship, right? Which we're going to do on Sunday. And doing kind of the basic things of living together in Christian community. And that also means learning together. That's going to look a little different this Sunday. Yes, Emily?
Yes. So this Sunday will look a little bit different than we had planned. As you might have known, this Sunday was going to be a class taught by Cynthia Lee and Ruth Myers. However, that's going to be postponed for a later time, likely in the fall. But for this Sunday, instead, Madeline Feely and Tony Martinez Borgfeldt are going to be teaching a class called Praying with Scripture. And so if you're looking for new ways of praying, and as we just articulated, there's a lot to be praying for. Tony and Madeline are going to lead us in new ways of praying and ways that we use scripture in our prayer lives. So that'll be this Sunday at 10:10 on Zoom. The link will be on our homepage, so you won't be able to miss it. And it'll also go out in the Pathfinder tonight, so you'll have it in two places. But we'd love if you joined us there and learn new and fresh ways that we can pray together in this new year. The other class is going to be taught by Phil and me, and this is a newcomer class. So Maggie, I invite you to join this class as well, because if you are new to All Souls in the last, whatever, year, 5 years, if you feel like 6 months, 2 weeks, 1 week, you haven't even attended All Souls before, you are invited to this class. We're going to look at our membership expectations at All Souls through the lens of our history, our values, and our practices. And so Phil and I are going to talk about kind of how some of the practices and the essence of All Souls came to be, as far as we know, and what we believe in. Kind of a chance to get to know each other as newerish people in the congregation. So if you're looking for an entry point into this community and the way we do things, or you're just curious, please come by. That's also 10:10 on Zoom. You can find the link on our homepage and again in the Pathfinder tonight.
Excellent.
Maggie?
Yeah.
Will you tell us what's going on at the church grounds these days?
Yeah. Jordan Court has a lot going on. And every time that I'm at the church, there's like seems to be a upward movement and new kind of materials showing up. And I've heard that there are some photos of something that happened this week that I have not yet seen that will be revealed. And I'm very excited.
First off, I didn't know that spraying concrete on walls is called shotcrete. Phil told me this earlier.
Yeah, so I've seen two things, gunite or shotcrete. I love both, like both words are really interesting to me.
They are, but I especially like shotcrete. It was like, oh, it's concrete that you shoot on a wall. Shotcrete, it's great.
Yes.
So it looks like we're looking at the garage walls here, the very, very bottom floor and building up from there.
And the shotcrete, this is what's happening right now.
Yeah, right. So that's what's going on right there.
Oh yeah, this is rad. Okay, so last time I was at the church, they had already built the platform for what's on top of this, so I haven't actually seen this.
Right.
This is exciting.
Isn't this cool?
So like those are the rebar walls, and rather than having to, I guess, build a form to pour into it, they're just like shooting it in
there. This is like every like construction less like, this is cool. I want to go over there just to watch.
And there it's finished right there. That's it.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
So then I also have a video of what it looks like now. And this is what's underneath all of that stuff.
Yeah.
So if All Soulsians come are going to park, say, if they're coming to the offices or something like that, or coming to visit, they will park in, this will be the parking lot you will eventually park in.
And you Woo-hoo. Too can scrape your bumper on these cement pillars. Or the side of your door. You can just sounds side like, your whole door.
Sounds like you're speaking from experience there, Maggie.
No.
Those are racing stripes.
Yes, exactly.
So at the end of the month, we have an annual tradition here at All Souls, the annual meeting. I'm curious to see, okay, so let's mark this point. So this is Thursday, January 7th. When we come back, the first Soulcast in February, I'm going to see if this lock-solid guarantee was met.
Okay.
That this parish meeting will not suck your will to live.
Okay, yeah, because that has been my experience of other parish meetings. So, yeah.
Okay, so that's our standard. And we'll see if this parish meeting coming up on Sunday, January 31st, 10:10, on a screen near you via Zoom, will meet that standard.
I'm looking forward to, I have a very low tolerance for meetings and high bar for things that don't suck my will to live. So I am really like, I'm not gonna hold any punches either. I'm gonna tell you how it is.
That's why I hired you. And many other reasons. Okay, so I think last but not least, I think Maggie, I think we should allow Emily to make an announcement.
Yes.
Well, it might not be as exciting as that reaction right there, but friends, All Souls has a brand new computer. Woo! And I'm using it right now. That means that we can edit videos off of this thing. It also means we can stream our Sunday services off of this so that Jim Feely can get a break from doing this every single Sunday and every single service we have. It also means that like, we have a lot of possibilities with how we do things virtually going forward. And as we know, that's kind of where we are for a bit longer. But also, I think some of the practices we hold now will stay on, even when we're meeting in person. And not putting all our hopes in a machine, but this particular machine is meant to last for a little while. And so it's pretty exciting to have all these capabilities going forward. So
great.
Yeah, also I also heard that the new MacBook Pros come with a feature where all emails will be replied to within 5 hours of getting them. So
good luck with that, yeah. I think that wraps up season 2 episode 16.
Ooh, almost
it is.